Good afternoon, my dear students. Welcome back to your online class. And in previous class, we have studied the chapter Transportation in Animals and Plants. There we have discussed what is transportation and what is circulatory system in human being and what are the main things circulatory system comprised of. And we have gone through blood vessels. And today I am going to discuss heart topic. In circulatory system, we have seen in blood there are different types of cells, RBC, WBC, platelets with their respective function. Okay, and we have also gone through the different types of blood vessels, arteries, veins and capillaries with their proper function. Now today I will discuss about heart. Okay, this is also a part of our circulatory system. Can you hear me properly, students? Please don't say give important MCQ question. The question will come from your book and from the told topic, okay, not outside from your book. What is this? Okay, I don't know about that, Anurag. So let's start your topic, that is heart. Let's revise. As you know, heart is an organ that which beats continuously to act pump for the transport of blood, then which carries other substance with it also. Okay, got this point, everyone? Any problem? Any problem? So how many chambers are there in our heart? Can anyone say how many chambers are there and name them? Name them. Yes, two chambers. So heart is a muscular organ in animals and that pumps blood through the blood vessel to all parts of the body. And heart consists of four chambers that prevent the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood from mixing. The upper chambers are called atrium and lower chambers are called ventricle. Atria. Atria in plural and atrium in singular, and ventricles in plural, they are found in lower chambers. Got this point? Now comes to valves. As you know, valves are present in the heart as well as in the veins. So what is the main function of valves? Valves are responsible for unidirectional flow of blood. Got this point, everyone? For unidirectional flow of blood. Okay, now opening and closing of valve present in the heart is responsible for lub-dub sound of the heart. Okay, you must remember this point. So you have come across the figure 11.3 from your book, page number 123. There you can see what is pulmonary circuit. Actually, it is the network of arteries and veins that is connected to heart and lungs. So this is the pulmonary circuit, and here the deoxygenated blood is pumped from the blood to the lungs for oxygenation, and the oxygenated blood returns to the heart to be pumped to the rest of the body. Got this point, everyone? So oxygenation of blood occurs at the alveoli in the lungs, and the alveoli have blood vessels that is wrapped around it, and the blood is oxygenated by a process called diffusion. Okay, now what is pulse rate? Pulse rate, actually heart periodically expands and contracts to pump blood into arteries, and which also expands and contract as the blood flows through them. So this is called pulsation. This pulsation is actually pulse rate. Okay, the pulsation of arteries that can be felt at certain place of our body. What is that certain place? Can anyone say? Can anyone write in your chat box? From where the pulse rate can be? I have asked. This can be felt at certain place of our body. What is that place? Pulsation of heartbeat. That can be felt at certain place of our body. Very good, Anusha. Answer will be wrist. So pulsation is the pulsation is measured as the number of heartbeats per minute. Okay, that is nothing but the pulse rate. Pulse rate and pulsation, that is the same thing. Okay, now comes to the next subtopic from your chapter transportation in animals and plants, that is excretion. Excretory system. Excretion is the process by which the removal of waste product from the cells of organisms, this is known as excretion. Now for human beings, waste products are in the form of carbon dioxide, urine and feces. Okay, now what is the major excretory organ of our body? Can anyone say what is the major excretory organ of our body? What is the major excretory organ? I have asked organ, not the product, excretory product. I have asked what is the major excretory organ of our body, not the major excretory product. Yes, very good, Aniruddha, Saptarshi, they have answered kidney. Saptarshi, if I ask you question that what is the major excretory product of human beings, then you must say urea. Okay, okay. So I hope you got this point. Now comes to kidney. As we know, our body's main excretory organ is kidney, and there is a pair of kidney that is present on either side of the spine. Okay, and each kidney is bean shaped and reddish in color. Okay, bean shaped and reddish in color, and it contains millions of tiny tubules that act as microscopic filters. Actually, in higher class you will come to know about the term. This microscopic filters is actually known as nephrons. There are so many nephrons are present in a kidney, so they actually act as microscopic filters. So what is the main function of here microscopic filters? They actually filter out the useful and harmful substance from the blood. Okay, so they filter out the useful and harmful substance from the blood, and the useful substance are again absorbed back into the blood, and only the harmful substance, these are concentrated, and this harmful substance are present in the dissolved state like our urine. Okay, now this urine, as you know, urine is excreted out of the body, and kidney, the kidney act as filter of our body. Got this point, everyone? Now an adult human being normally passes 1 to 1.8 liter of urine in 24 hours. Now what is the main contents of urine? Urine contains 95% water, 2.5% urea and 2.5% other waste. Okay, now on the basis of excretory product in animals can be actually categorized into three groups: aminotelic, uricotelic and ureotelic. Aminotelic means where the organism's excretory product is ammonia. There the animals are known as aminotelic. Just like aminotelic aquatic feces, their excretory product is ammonia. So these are called aminotelic. Now the animals whose excretory product is urea, just like human beings, they are called ureotelic. Okay, and the organisms, living organisms whose excretory products are uric acid, they are known as uricotelic. Got this point, everyone? Just for example, uricotelic, you know, birds, lizard, frogs. Okay, so these all are the example of uricotelic animals. Okay, got this point? 2.5% other waste, not only salt. Okay, so we have seen the different category of animal on the basis of their excretory product. Now sometimes when kidney may stop working due to infection or injury, then what happens? Actually, as a result, kidney failures. Now waste products starts accumulating in the blood, so such person cannot survive unless the blood is filtered periodically through an artificial machine known as artificial kidney. So this process is known as dialysis. Okay, so you got this point, what is dialysis? I hope you got this point. Okay, now comes to transport of substance in plants. Now can you say what are the major things which are transported in the plants? can you write in your chat box? Can you write in your chat box, students? Yes, right. Please write first. Water and minerals, as you know, okay, these are the main things. Now also food, and as you know, where the food is manufactured, that is in the leaves, okay. So actually transport of water and mineral actually takes place by a vascular tissue known as, please write in your chat box, a group of cell that perform the specialized function, that is known as tissue. So vascular tissue, that is the function of xylem to transport food and to transport water and minerals. Now to transport food, which vascular tissue play a major role, that is phloem. Very good. So we have gone through this point also. Now comes to the another point, that is transpiration. As you know, the process of or the loss of water from the stomata of the leaf, that is known as transpiration, as you know. And another thing, the continuous evaporation of the water from the leaves produce an upward pull, that is known as suction force. Okay, and this force pulls the water from the roots upwards through the stem, branches, and finally to the leaves. Okay, and through this transpiration causes loss of water from the plants. Still, it is very necessary process for plants due to following reason. Why? Because suction pull causing due to evaporation of water helps to draw water to a great height in tall trees. They need produce cooling effect on the plant, therefore prevents the plants from damage causing by heat or sunlight. Okay, now it also helps in transport of water minerals through the leaves for performing photosynthesis in them. So you have got all the points, all the subtopics from this topic. I hope you understood, and if you have any problem you can tell me now. Okay, any problem up to this portion, students? Okay, I hope you understood, and in the next day I will revise the next chapter. So be ready for that chapter. Okay.